Hello, everybody. This is Paul Cheon, and welcome to M14 draft number two. I thought I was going to be able to draft the set a few more times before recording another one, but time is not something that I have too much of, so we will be learning together, basically. So this is my second draft, and this is the second draft that we will be doing together. So let's hop straight into this pack, and let's see what we have. So, let's see. Let's read Savage Summoning. Okay. Now, I'm not a huge fan of Savage Summoning because although it's kind of cool that you can actually ambush a creature, it is kind of card disadvantage unless you can actually eat the creature and you still leave yourself open to combat tricks and stuff like that. So I don't like a card that's kind of like a built-in 2-for-1. Built-in 2-for-1 against you. So I don't really want to be taking that. Things that I want to consider here are basically the Charging Griffin, the Colonian Tusker, and I suppose the Pitchburn Devils and Essence Scatter. A Cursed Spirit is also a reasonable card, so there's actually a playable card in each color. From what I've been told, or from what I've read, I read a post by Rich Hohen. He said white is by far the weakest color in this format, so I guess we're going to try to avoid that. Then it becomes a choice between the other cards, and I think I'm going to take the Tusker here. Green seems really deep. I think I want to be green, and if I take the Tusker here, it allows me to take something like a Force Mage Advocate early. The fact that it's a beast is pretty huge, and allows for some pretty silly draws. I've lost several games already in this format where my opponent just went turn 2 Tusker, turn 3 Advocate. All right, so this pack was loaded. A rare was taken out of the pack, but there's still a bunch of playable cards in this pack. So cards to look at here, Liturgy of Blood, very fine removal spell. Marauding Maulhorn, very good aggressively costed creature. Claustrophobia, Pacifism, premium removal spell, one of the best commons in the set, if not the best, but it is white. Darksteel Ingot and Air Servant. So I'm going to take the Air Servant here. It is splashable, and it's just a giant flying beater. It looks like we're starting out blue-green again, which is what we did in the last draft. I can definitely see, but the thing is, I feel like Air Servant is just so much better than the other cards that I want to take it. Like, between Air Servant and Claustrophobia, I think I like Air Servant better. Just a bigger beater, and it just rules the skies. I could also take Pacifism, but I think blue-green is a better color combination than green-white, so I'm going to take the Air Servant. Now, if you wanted to try green-black, Liturgy of Blood is certainly something that I wouldn't be opposed to if you took that. And besides, we're not married to being green after the first pick. What I do know is that I like blue because of the fact that I did get past an Air Servant. An Air Servant is very, very good. So no green cards in this pack. There is a Corrupt, however. And taking a Corrupt this early, there's a lot of upside there. You know, you can draft a black heavy deck if you take cards like this from the get-go. We're not really missing out on much here. There's an Essence Scatter here, which, you know, it's a reasonable card and you almost always play it, but I actually think I want to take the Corrupt here and see if we can go maybe a black heavy deck, splashing perhaps an Air Servant. I know we passed the Liturgy of Blood, but hopefully, you know, we can cut off enough black afterwards so that we can get hooked up in the next pack. It's unlikely, but, you know, there's nothing green here, and the only thing we're really missing out on is an Essence Scatter out of this pack. And I do like the upside of Corrupt overtaking something like a Child of Night or an Undead Minotaur. At least, you know, third pick into the draft. Okay, so what do we have here? Gale Rider Sliver. Sliver control creatures you control have flying. That guy's actually pretty nice if you wanted to draft a Sliver deck, which we may or may not be, which we may or may not try to draft. The problem is with the blue Slivers is that there really isn't any other blue Sliver, I don't think. This guy is good and all, but it's good with, you know, if you have a bunch of muscle Slivers and stuff. So I don't think I want to just go try and take the Slivers. Flesh Pulper Giant is something that I feel like they could have made it cost 6 and it would have been reasonable. 7's a little too expensive for my tastes. I'm going to go ahead and just take the Trained Condor here. Very, very quality common. Gives your ground creatures flying, 3-drop. Does basically everything you want. Root Wall is also an option, but after taking the Corrupt here, I'd rather take the blue card because I know for sure that I'm playing the Air Servant. And Air Servant comboed also with Trained Condor is a pretty nice combination. Too bad it's not target creature, because then there could be like a minor synergy here where you can give opponent's creature flying and then tap it down with the Air Servant. You know, the little things. All right, and then we have this pack, which is stone unplayables. Yeah, not a black card, there is no green card, and there is no blue card. I don't really consider Armored Cancrix a card, really. It's not something that I would ever really consider playing, and it's one of, you know, something that you take really, really late. So here it's basically, should I just take a like a combat trick here if we do happen to go into blue white or a Cyclops Tyrant or a negate? I don't like taking negate this early either, so I'm just gonna take the Show of Valor. I don't think we're passing too many signals. It's, you know, highly unlikely that we end up in white, but there were, that pack was really, really bad. All right, so this pack basically gives us several choices. There are some black creatures here: Corpse Hauler, Deathgaze Cockatrice, and there's also an Essence Scatter and a Disperse. I'm actually a pretty big fan of the Deathgaze Cockatrice. It's a little clunky in that it costs four, but it, you know, it actually just blocks and kills anything. It's basically like a Deadly Recluse, but if they have nothing on the board, it also gives you evasion. Now, black does have a fair amount of four drops, so you might want to stay away, but I'm actually going to take it here. I think I like it a little more than the Essence Scatter, you know, especially because we did take the Corrupt, and I want to see if blue-black is something that we can possibly go into. You know, the safer pick would have been Essence Scatter, because then we'd be like for sure blue paired with another color, but I feel like black is something that we might want to be interested in going. Ooh, Mark of the Vampire. I've been pretty impressed with this guy, especially so far. I mean, we have three black flyers, and it's a lot better when you put it on an evasion creature. Once again, not too much we're missing out on here. There's like a negate, a fortify, and a little fixing here. Right, so no blue cards, no black cards. What does this guy do? Sack six creatures. Yeah, that's never gonna happen. I don't know if there's any lands worth killing with Encroaching Waste. I think the best card here, or there's two cards to consider. I guess there's the Blur Sliver and the Academy Raider. I think I like the Academy Raider a little bit more. We do have the Mark of the Vampire. It's got Intimidate, so you never know. All right, so I'm gonna take the Nightwing Shade here out of a bunch of suboptimal cards. And here I will. Oh, man. This pack is pretty bad. There is like an Altar's Reap or an Ingot. I don't really like Altar's Reap that much. So I'll take the Ingot in case we go some kind of dirtily control deck. All right, Minotaur Abomination is not the worst. You know, I don't mind really playing it in my deck. It's a, you know, good way to top off the curve, I guess. So yeah, Flesh Pulper Giant still in the pack, and we are not going to take it. I'm going to take the Tutor here in case we open some kind of awesome bomb. So I mean, it looks like black is where we want to be. We did pass the Liturgy of Blood, and we took an Air Servant over it, but not too upset so far with our deck. I kind of want to lower our curve. We want to be able to pick up some more low drops here. So things like good low drops that you want in blue black are basically the one in a blue 1/3 flyer that's blue, and the Child of Night and Corpse Hauler. So there's actually a decent amount of twos that you can pick up along with Essence Scatter, which we passed quite a few of those already in the draft. All right, what does this guy do? He's big. Enters battlefield with X counters. When it dies, you may distribute a number of +1/+1 counters equal to the number of +1/+1 counters on Vastward among any number of creatures you control. That guy seems sick. That guy, I mean, that thing's ridiculous, right? Okay, so it's between two cards in my mind. Opportunity is something that's amazing in my mind, in my opinion. And we do have already a couple blue cards. I don't think we want to play the Cancrix, but I know we have a Tusker, but it was pretty clear that green was cut off in the first pack. So, you know, whoever's passing us the green, we're going to reward them by passing the Hydra. Because even if we were to take this now, we're only going to end up getting green in this pack, and then we're going to get completely cut off in the green in the last pack. And we already have a few top-end cards here. And Opportunity might not even be that much worse than Vastward Hydra. It's certainly one of the best cards in this set. So I'm going to take the Opportunity here. Besides, we have like an ingot to ramp into it too. All right. So it looks like we're looking to be some kind of a blue-black control deck. This is the lone Wrath effect in the set, so it's worth noting that we did pass this. We passed some white, so I'm kind of surprised. I guess, white is not the best, and this card is a little bit slow. What was taken out of this pack? It looks like a common was taken out of this pack. So what blue-black cards are there? There is a Wall of Frost, and I actually feel like this is a Wall of Frost deck, so I'm going to take it here. We're not missing out on too much. There is a sensory deprivation, but those are easier to come by than a card like Wall of Frost. Darksteel Ingot could also be a reasonable pickup here, but I don't really want too many of them, I'd rather just be able to curve out and play something like a wall and shut them down and then, get card advantage later. All right, so here are the low drops that we were talking about. There's both a Corpse Hauler and a Gnawing Zombie. I think I like the Gnawing Zombie more, just because it's a little bit bigger, blocks a few more things, and its effect is actually pretty decent if you have some Festering Newts and stuff like that. And if we, happen to splash like Pitchburn Devils or whatever, it's also better. But here I'm gonna just take the Liturgy of Blood. We have a bunch of black things, so being able to Liturgy Blood into some kind of creature or spell or whatever seems pretty nice. Okay. What do we want? All right. So Archaeomancer is decent, but I don't want to take it that early. We have, I guess, four spells for it. And it is good at this type of deck, but I'd rather kind of like look to take something cheaper, and there are actually two very strong options here. There's both a Seacoast Drake and a Warden of Evos Isle. I'm gonna take the Warden because we already have several flyers here. We have three other flyers. No, we have four other flyers, which makes this a lot better. It makes all of our flyers cheaper, which is nice. And it's an uncommon, so it's kind of harder to come by. Like I said before, there is a decent amount of blue and black two drops, so I want to take something that's a little bit harder to obtain. And I think the Warden is actually just a good card, so we will take that and move on to the next pack. So there's a little, nice little black-red sack theme here. You have both the Warlord and the Barrage of Expendables, which are pretty nice. And I really do want to draft the black-red sacrifice deck at some point. But here, those are not cards we're looking for. We're not really a Frostbreath deck. I like Frostbreath in decks that are looking to tempo out your opponents. If you're more of a control deck, I don't like the effect as much. So here it becomes a choice of whether or not we want Time Ebb, Accursed Spirit, and Ring Flesh. I'm just going to go ahead and take the Ring Flesh here. Accursed Spirit's fine, but it's another 4 drop. Time Ebb is okay, but we have several 3s. Ring Flesh is not like the best card, but I definitely do want to have at least one of this type of effect in my deck. To basically be able to interact with your opponents early, and the fact that we have stuff like Opportunity makes it so that we can afford to play stuff like Ring Flesh and not worry too much about it being a dead card, basically. Wow, this pack is loaded. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, like 8 playables in this pack. This pack must have been insane. Chandra's Phoenix is pretty strong. Celestial Flare is good. Here, I'm just going to go ahead and take the Phantom Warrior. 2-2 unblockable, pretty strong, low drop creature, and an excellent Mark of the Vampire target. Here, I'm just going to go ahead and take the Negate. It's a reasonable sideboard card, I think. Okay. Well, as much as I want to take a Child of Night here, I think Liturgy of Blood is probably Black's best common. So I'm just going to go ahead and take that. Eighth pick, Liturgy of Blood. Wow. So I kind of wish my low drops were like my 3 drops were black. So I got to be on the lookout for stuff like that too. Because Liturgy, once you cast this, you want to be able to get your tempo back by playing something afterwards. Here I'm going to take an Archaeomancer. We now have a Ring Flesh, a Tutor, two Liturgy of Bloods, Corrupt, and Opportunity. So this guy can be very, very playable. All right, here I'm going to take the ingot, and it's actually very possible that we're going to play it because we do have a pretty top end curve here, and it does help us ramp into some of our more expensive and powerful spells. I'll just take another tutor. It's probably we're not going to play them, but just taking them. Traumatize. Yeah, the more, I mean, I don't know, was there like a Child of Night in the pack where there was the Phantom Warrior? We could have considered just taking a black creature instead. I took the Phantom Warrior because in a vacuum, it's just a better card. But it looks like we want to be really black heavy and we have Corrupt.